My next question, Swamiji. You have downloaded agama-based food for us, agama-based yoga. You have explained about agama-based marriage. So it sounds like a parallel world almost, which is many years before. Is there agama-based entrepreneurship or trade and commerce?
Yes.
Agama-based.
Agama-based economy policies are there.
Can you download it for us, Swamiji?
Actually, I already got the sutras. I meant to translate, that's all.
Wow.
Once I even spoke about the economic policies of Sadashiva in satsang. I allowed to detail. Even if I am not able to translate, I commit with you guys, I will give at least 25 satsang. All the major points of entrepreneurship and economic policies of Sadashiva.
Can you please, Swamiji, because that is going to be the most unique thing.
I'll do it.
Today's modern world.
I'll do it.
Agama-based business.
Yes, that's what. Agama's definition, descriptions of economic policies and entrepreneurship. I'll do both.
Swamiji, after doing all this, in what dimension are you while in Samadhi?
I should say space.
Space?
Space.
So you don't get any thought process?
There is no thought. Even now, when you are talking, response is coming.
Yeah.
In the gap, there is no thought.
No thought.
It's a pure space.
Can I ask one more thing, Swamiji? Yes. Can we get next 5 days like this with you?
Tatast.
Thank you, Swami.
Actually, I am planning to be here more time. You see, it is not that I have some other work, so I am not here. I am waiting to be here, but some of the preparations you guys need to go through has to happen. That is why I am sitting. That's all.
Because this interaction is so phenomenal. It is more than alchemy, it is more than completion, it is more than everything. It's
Sadhya Jata.
Swamiji, Sadhya
Jata.
I have a question about the third
eye. Jata.
Sadhya Jata, Swami.
Let me look into Sadhya Jata. Go ahead.
Swamiji, that day when we went to Melkote, I think there was a news.
No. You need to be a little slow and put the mic closer. You have to,
Swamiji.
See, you need to remember I'm a village boy. And my Italy accent you have to speak. Go ahead.
Swamiji, when we went to Melkote, I think there the news has taken about you. And my sister in Kuwait, she saw you in the news. And I've seen your YouTube and I've been going through your morning satsang also from the month of March. And that day, you came in my sister's dream. And for me, I've come to Sadashiva. It's happened for me. But how does that, she doesn't even know about you and you've been in
her
dream.
She need to know about me. She need to know about me, that's all.
Vamadeva.
Thank you so much.
Vamadeva.
Vamadeva. Swamiji. 50 years ago, I knew nothing about Kundalini and all this. And it was a very great surprise to me when suddenly I realized now I got entangled with an enlightened being. And I was suddenly found myself with Kundalini coming up 3.5 times. And what I really wanted to know was when it sort of went up to my brain, there was for a second a whirl, and then it looked as if it came out of the fontanelle, and my skull changed shape. Instead of being round, there's a dip, like as if the bone had gone.
What you went through is the right experience. Sometimes, if the toxins are too much in the body, it alters even the shape of the body.
And the enlightened being died, and after his death, you can see this in the photos, his skull changed shape completely. It was much bigger and more radiant, and I was later to be told that it meant that he died by the 10th gate.
He should left the body by the 10th gate. Not died by the 10th gate, ma. You see, nine holes are there in the body.
Yeah.
This is the 10th hole. This is called Sahasrara. Through this opening, he left the body.
Yes.
Means he will never assume one more body. He will be a liberated being.
Yes. And when you look at the pictures See, and statues.
For all the male, this 21 finger, 20 fingertips on the genital is the energy going out point. And all the male, heart and the sahasrara is the energy coming in point. So through this in, if you leave, you will never come in again.
A goal.
And in, may I just continue? In the...
Now you understood what I said now?
Yeah. I was just... Because in the ancient Chinese statues of sages, they have these bloated skulls. So I wanted to know more about the importance
of the
skull.
Actually, the bloated skull is one of the Jiva Samadhi definition. Means one of the symptoms when somebody's kundalini reaches the crown and explodes and leaves the body. The skull sometimes become even two times bigger.
Yes.
Satyoja, Swamiji.
You are done? Yes. Next.
Namaste, Swamiji. My question is about deja vu. The first week you briefly touched upon it. Could you please expand on it, how it relates to these dimensions?
I should say, most of your ideas about deja vu is not required. Okay. And even if it has happened earlier, it is not something great. What is happening now, catch it, that's more than enough.
Okay, thank you, Swamiji.
Okay. Your dimensions are far more deeper than any deja vu.
Sorry, Swamiji?
Dimensions are far more deeper than deja vu.
Okay.
Tatpurusha.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Vamadeva is the word first I heard. So go ahead.
Yes. Your purpose is a function of your will persistence. Is that right? Convincing yourself. It's not something...
Understand,
I mean, what about the reincarnation?
Convincing yourself.
Huh?
Understanding and convincing yourself.
Okay, I think the understanding part is... because I try all these different things and reach a certain level of success, and then I sort of lose
more and
interest.
More contemplation will lead to more and more understanding. More and more understanding will lead to more and more convincing. More and more convincing will lead to more and more integrity. More and more integrity leads to more and more Sadashivatva.
Can I ask you a quick question?
Yes, go ahead.
About coincidence, can you say something about that?
There's no such thing as coincidence.
Okay.
Coincident. How can be coincident? Coincident. How can be coincident?
Okay.
See the word. Divide them. That makes meaning. When you unite, you make them very light.
Okay. Well, you had mentioned the word coincidence.
Combination of incidents is coincidence. Not accidental combination of incidents is coincidence.
So how do you know which one is accidental?
Nothing is accidental. Even accident is not accidental.
Okay. So then how do you
accident
look at it?
Accident means unexpected. That does not mean all the ingredients are not made. Accident, because it is unexpected, you call it as accident. Otherwise, it is the incident which has all the ingredients of incident. For an incident, whatever ingredients are required, all those incidents are there in the accident. But the outcome is unexpected. That is, you did not expect, does not change. The ingredients of the incident are the accident.
But can we overemphasize the significance of a coincidence because, you know, we weren't expecting
actually,
it?
We actually take coincidence too lightly.
Okay.
Coincidence should be taken as coincidence. Okay. Remove the C and put TS and give a gap. Coincidence.
Thank you.
Satya Jata.
Satya Jyota.
Satya Jata.
Pranam Swamiji.
Yes, go ahead.
Swamiji, actually, whatever you
mic
told,
closer.
Swamiji, whatever you tell us in the satsang, you take it as guru walk and start living. And that four tattvas also, meaning I started living the same way. And because of that living, that we've been tested every time. But because the trust or guru, no, guru can't go wrong. Whatever he is telling, it's a life, we have to start living. The test, when we are going through the test, for the next 1 week or 10 days, not able to listen to any of the satsangs.
Meaning see, listen. Whenever you stand with the truth, guru can't go wrong. Even if you go through the test, I decide the result. All the powers I manifest will be there supporting you. Do not bother about that few days of tests. Most painful test will be, even from guru, you will be kept little away. Even during that test, stand with guru's words. Guru walk is many times more powerful than guru himself.
Actually, I have seen the power of it, Swamiji. Whatever files go wrong, that alone will come up on top. And like, you know, that more and more I started living that because of that, the four sattvas.
Sometimes your will persistence need to be tested. Understand? Before, you see that, there is a, in Agamic tradition, even in Ayurveda, there's something called Sparshamani. That Sparshamani, whatever it touches, it will become gold. But before the Sparshamani touches, that metal need to be boiled, heated up, melted and solidified. All the dust in the metal need to go out. So before I make your will into my will, I need to make and test all your will with your will persistence.
Thank you, Swami.
Okay.
One more.
Actually, your will persistence need to be tested before I declare your will as my will.
Thank you, Swami. Actually, this 2 years when I was going through this thing, the only thing which was put, meaning of course people around me, they told, you will lose your job, you will lose your job. But in
you will not lose anything other than the losers in your life. Losers who go on discouraging your life, only that you will lose. Nothing else you will lose.
No, actually, Samaji, at the end of the second year, I won the confidence of all the people who work with me, which my boss did not like. And he said, finally, he also got convinced. He was ready to pay me more and keep me in the job. But at that time, I did not feel like working for him.
I tell you guys, see, take this as a principle. I wanted to make this statement. All my disciples will be their own bosses. If you want, take 1 year. Make it as a project. Because I know many of you cannot give up your job and become your own boss immediately. But at least decide, by 1 year, I will become my boss. Or 2 years. Have some clear project, goal. But becoming your boss should be your goal. Why, you know? All the powers I am manifesting through you, let it be useful for you. Why should somebody else use your powers? Now, it is not that you can stop, oh, I will not use all these powers because after all, my boss is going to be benefited. You can't do that. That's wrong. Manifest powers, become your boss at least in next 1 year.
Thank you, Swami.
Understand, I tell you, it is a spiritual instruction, not social. Spiritual instruction. Only if you are your boss, you will break the inertness, boredom, tiredness pattern. Otherwise, you will always be thinking your life is going to be useful for somebody. So you do not need to break your tiredness. You only have to learn the cunning way of justifying to your boss that you are doing what he wants. Understand? Suppressed lion will become fox. It's a line from Vivekananda. If you are working under somebody, you will never completely integrate you. Be your boss. Spiritually, it benefits you. spiritually it benefits you. Maybe take 2 years for transition. Take 2 years for transition. Anjuvadum adimanuvadum appan oruvanukke means bowing down, reverence, respect, everything only for Sadashiva, nothing else.
Actually, I'm also a very scared person only. So do not take decisions like that. But from Vishesha Deeksha, that powerfulness, I will never bow my head down for anyone else for my guru or for
I tell you, be your boss. If you are not, take this as my instruction. At least in next 1 year or 2 years, be your boss. Remember this statement, my disciples have to be boss for themselves. So keep this as a line. Swamiji said his disciples have to be boss for himself. Then only when I become boss for myself, I am his disciple. I am complete. Understand, your day managed by somebody else for somebody else is a crime done to your consciousness. Even if you are sleeping out of tiredness, tamas, everything, let the good and bad be on your own. Let the good and bad be on your own. You be responsible. I tell you, money is needed to play within the matrix, to have some comforts. Be brilliant enough to be your boss and generate that money. Never sell your life, which is literally, you see, your time is money for your boss, but your time is life for you.
Actually, when I made this decision or something, that day only you spoke this satsang.
I'm telling you, your life is, your time is money for your boss. For somebody it may be their, whatever, their shopping expense. For somebody it's different. For your friend it may be attention. For your lover it may be love. Whatever. But your time is your life. Remember, your customers, clients can be your boss. Nothing wrong. It's an integrity understanding. But do not have a single boss who decides what you should think, what you should feel, how your day should be. I say, a Shaivite, my disciple, cannot be under anybody. Your life should be under your control. You should decide when to wake up, when to do what to do, when to engage yourself in the business. See, you should know very clearly, money is only to play within the matrix. And I'll awaken enough intelligence in you, making the money within the matrix by making the cosmic money, cosmic currency. Living in Advaita develops cosmic currency. With that, without compromising on it, you can make the country currency. So remove respect for all this boss, leader, team. Whole thing is faltuma. Why do you guys die for somebody becoming rich? Either you be a leader and fulfill your dreams, or somebody will hire you to fulfill theirs.